Number 10, the Dead Sea Scrolls. Discussing bizarre historical findings of all time without mentioning the Dead Sea Scrolls is like discussing the most beautiful natural wonders of the world without mentioning my face. But for all you who fell asleep during history lessons at school, what exactly are they? Well, according to Wikipedia, because if you think you're getting more in-depth research than that, you're having a laugh, the Dead Sea Scrolls are ancient Jewish religious manuscripts found in the Qumran caves in the Judean desert near Ein Feshka on the northern shore of the Dead Sea. These scrolls hold huge historical, religious, and linguistic significance because they are the second oldest known manuscripts of works later included in the Hebrew Bible canon. So, you know. The first set of the Dead Sea Scrolls were accidentally discovered in 7 clay jars by teenage shepherds in late 1946 or early 1947. They were made out of leather and papyrus. The scrolls passed through various scholars who estimated them to be more than 2,000 years old. After the initial discovery, treasure hunters scoured the nearby caves and managed to unearth more scroll fragments. They comprised over 800 manuscripts, to be precise. So, you know, as far as scrolls go, the Dead Sea Scrolls are probably the second most important scrolls to ever exist, after the Elder Scrolls, of course. Number 9. Nanmadol. In Micronesia, best known as being the baby brother of Macronesia, is Nanmadol, the only ever ancient city to have been built upon a coral reef. When I said about it being the baby brother of Macronesia, just a stupid joke, but the whole city built on top of a coral reef thing? Somehow, that is not a joke. Seriously. Built atop 100 artificial islands, Nanmadol is an absolute marvel of engineering. The only ancient city ever to have been built upon a coral reef. Built upon roughly 100 artificial islands, it is truly an engineering marvel. Archaeologists just have to figure out the how, when, and why. There are no known records in existence to explain the ancient city's existence. Most inhabitants of Pompeii believe the legendary explanation for Nanmadol. It began with the arrival of twin sorcerers, Olasipa and Olasopa, who hailed from western Katao. The brothers sought a place to build an altar for Nanasan Sapu, the god of agriculture. After successfully building their altar, they used it to perform rituals to levitate the huge stones with the help of a flying dragon. Number 8. The Baghdad Battery. Discovered in a village in Iraq, the Baghdad Battery is an intriguing example of ancient technology. It's almost comparable to all the brilliant prehistoric versions of modern technology you see in episodes of the Flintstones. It's comprised of three parts: a ceramic pot, a copper tube, and an iron rod. Some believe that it was used to electroplate gold onto silver objects, but this claim was never proven, nor is there any evidence to support it. Ancient astronaut theorists think that similar devices were used as a light source inside pyramids by ancient Egyptians. If true, it just goes to show how little we really know about the past. We far too often think of people of the past as limited by technology, but look how brilliantly progressive they could be. Like, this is Da Vinci level brilliant. A researcher named Dr. Arnie Egerbeck was the first person to look at the pot and wonder if it worked as a battery. Building a replica, he used grape juice as an acid and a thin layer of silver, which supposedly resulted in the production of electricity. If the Baghdad battery was what its name suggests, it would predate Alessandro Volta's electrochemical cell by a millennium. Number 7. The Dropa Stones. The Dropa Stones, if they were real, were reportedly found in the mountains of Bayan Karaula, right on the border between China and Tibet. They are said to have been discovered in 1938 by a Chinese professor, Chi Pu Te. The skeletons inside were small in height, 122 centimeters or 4 feet tall, and had large, overdeveloped skulls. Chi Pu Te and his team found some interesting rock art inside a nearby cave system, which depicted figures with round helmets. There were also engravings of the sun, moon, earth, and stars. Once they ventured further into the cave, the team found a collection of 716 stone discs. Most of them were half buried in the ground. The Dropa stones allegedly have hieroglyphic-like markings, date back around 12,000 years, and measure up to 30 centimeters or 12 inches in diameter, each with a hole in the middle. In 1962, a researcher by the name of Su Mung Nui from Beijing University reportedly claimed to have deciphered the hieroglyphic characters after 4 years of study. Yet, after he published his findings in a professional journal, he became a laughingstock. According to his work, one of the discs held this exact quote: "The Dropa came down from the clouds in their aircraft. Our men, women, and children hid in the caves 10 times before sunrise. When at last we understood the sign language of the Dropas, we realized that the newcomers had peaceful intentions." Number 6. The London Hammer. It may sound like the name of a really average band, but the London Hammer is far more interesting than that. In the middle of 1934, Max Hahn, a resident of London, Texas, discovered an odd-looking rock on a ledge beside a waterfall. The rock was apparently very happy to see him, judging by the piece of wood protruding from it. Max took it back to introduce it to his family, and they cracked the rock open with a hammer and a chisel. Like a Kinder Egg, but for old tools instead of toys, they found an old hammer inside the rock. Now, here's where things get weird. Not as weird as my mom's new boyfriend, but still weird. The rock is purported to be 400 million years old. Humans aren't supposed to have evolved until hundreds of millions of years later. So if humans weren't using tools back then, where on earth did the hammer come from? Number 5. The Saqqara Bird. Who'd have thought the part of the world that brought us triangular stone structures, a riddle-dispensing sphinx, and a secret underground library would be such a hotbed for cool and bizarre stuff? Here's another one to add to the laundry list of interesting things about ancient Egypt. The Saqqara bird. Found in Saqqara, Egypt in 1898, the Saqqara bird is an artifact made of wood and estimated to be approximately 2,200 years old. Almost as old as your mom. Although its shape resembles a bird, it appears to display features of a modern airplane, with the head being the only exception. Reportedly inscribed on the artifact are hieroglyphs translating to the gift of Amon, and three papyri found near the artifact are said to have mentioned the phrase, I want to fly. Number 4. The Piri Reis Map. Way back in 1929, German theologian Gustav Deissmann was working at the Top Copy Place Library in Istanbul. It was just an ordinary date filing away antique items, but then things took a turn. He came across a peculiar-looking gazelle skin parchment on top of a stack of discarded items. And no, it wasn't Hagrid's Monster Book of Monsters. Upon taking a closer look, he was surprised to see something made out of animal skin showing the outline of South America. He picked it out of the heap to study. It was drawn and signed in 1513 by a Turkish cartographer named Hagi Ahmed Muhiddin Piri, also known as Piri Reis. His sources for the map included 8 Ptolemaic maps, 4 Portuguese maps, an Arabic map, and one drawn by Christopher Columbus. Here's where it gets weird. According to some, not only does this map show Antarctica almost 300 years before it was officially discovered, but it supposedly shows the continent as it would have appeared before it was covered with ice. Number 3. The Stone Walls of Sacsayhuaman. On the northern outskirts of the city of Cusco in Peru lies the walled complex of, and I will pronounce this wrong so get over it, Sacsayhuaman. The halls are made out of boulders carefully cut to fit together tightly without the use of mortar. This level of precision fitting is unmatched in the Americas. This, not to mention the variance of shapes interlocking as well as the walls leaning forward somehow, has baffled scientists for decades. Number 2. The Paracas Skulls. Would you look at that? It's proof that SNL's coneheads were real. Well, not quite, but maybe. At the Museo Regional de Ica, you'll find some oddly shaped skulls on display. Throughout history, different cultures have changed the shape of their children's skulls by tying 2 wooden boards to their heads and making them fit tighter day by day. Gruesome, right? The Paracas skulls were discovered in the Paracas Peninsula on the southern coast of Peru. Peruvian archaeologist Julio Teo found them back in 1928, along with a complex graveyard. The Paracas skulls are said to be missing sagittal sutures, the fixed joint you typically see across the top of a human skull. They don't look human at all. So what are they? It has been repeatedly claimed that when DNA testing was carried out in 2014, it was found that the Paracas skulls have mitochondrial DNA with mutations unknown to any human, primate, or animal known so far. Number 1. Your mom. Your mom is so old and bizarre, she's easily the most historical finding of all time. Just kidding. The actual final thing on our list is... Number 1. The Antikythera Mechanism. 3 flat pieces of bronze were recovered from an ancient Greek shipwreck off the coast of Antikythera between 1900 and 1901. Scholars had no idea what they were at the time, nor were they able to figure anything out about it for decades to come. Over time, the discs started to corrode into different shades of green, obscuring some of the crucial details of the discovery. For years, the 3 mysterious pieces of bronze were forgotten. It wasn't until Mike Edmonds from Cardiff University in Wales decided to publish CT scans of the discs in 2006 that real interest in the Antikythera mechanism started to pick up. Not only did it resemble technology that was shockingly modern for the time from which it originated, but the CT scans revealed more details of the device's inner workings and hidden inscriptions. The mechanism resembled a mantle clock. The case would have had to have featured a large, circular face with rotating hands. There also had to have been some kind of knob or handle on the side for winding the mechanism forward or backward. If you fiddled with the knob, gear wheels inside would have driven at least 7 hands at various speeds, as opposed to the 2 or 3 in a typical clock. What's super weird is that it wasn't tracking hours or minutes, it kept track of celestial time. There was a hand for the sun, one for the moon, and one for each of the 5 planets visible to the naked eye. A black and silver ball rotating around along with the other hands represented the phases of the moon. Space clock!